Welcome back to the channel. We're jumping straight into the action. Let's get going. This is 31T. Now, I didn't get a good shot at this. This is one of those trains where you get here last minute. And by last minute, I mean you get the horn from your house and you go running towards the nearest spot. This train, the 31T, is been to New York, Montreal, Quebec, Canada. This train has three different railroads that take care of this train. That being Norfolk Southern, Canadian Pacific, and the Canadian National. Did I say last minute trains? Oh yeah, the next one, NS 264, was the last minute. I was walking from the school to football practice when I heard the horn of NS 1001. T64 is Chicago, Illinois' 41st Street Yard in the Mechanicsville. However, the single stacks go all the way up to Massachusetts, AR, where Pan Am takes over. However, they keep the NS power all the way to Massachusetts. Later that night, 264's counterpart, the 265, will come south with an SD60 and 2-9s. 265 is Mechanicsville to Chicago, Illinois' 43rd Street Yard. And again, in reality, the originating point was there in Massachusetts. And they picked up the double stacks and garbage in Mechanicsville. We'll be right back. The next train is a non-regular scheduled BOWS train, NS92X, northbound with a GREX BOWS set. This train had two SD70 ACs as power, 1159 and 1082. The next night, it's 16R. 16R is Binghamton, New York to Mechanicsville, New York, where the Pan Am takes over and brings it to Deerfield, Massachusetts. On the next night, 265 came south with SD60, 6959, SD78, 1001, and -9, 9820. The three engines are running elephant style, no engines facing backwards, all forward. A couple days later, 92X would come down south after its journey north. This time, the two SD70 ACs are running long hood forward, southern style. The Southern Railway was known to run their engines long hood forward. The crew aboard this train was very friendly, as I got a nice shave and a haircut. There's another nickname for running long hood forward, hammerhead style, because the radiators make the back of the engine look like the head of a hammerhead shark. Later on in the night, 16R came north with an SD6E, AC44C6M, and an SD78. And yet the next day, another 16R, an SD60, an ES44AC, and an AC44C6M. Now hang on a second, have I shown this 265 before? Well, yes, technically, it's the same engines, but they're leading once again and in the same way. Huh, looks the exact same. I promise, it's not the same train. Same engines with the same train symbol, running the same way on a different night. What is different about this 265 is that there was another train following, 30T, with an SD70 AC, 1179 leading, ES44 AC, 8162, and AC44 C6M, 4120 trailing. I'm sorry, 4201. My apologies. And as a side note, the K5 LLA that's on 1179 is one of my favorite horns of all time. Here is another 265 with SD60 6953 leading 2-9s, one in the thoroughbred scheme and the other in the horsehead scheme. later that night, 31T came up north. An AC44 CXM leading an SD70 AC. This SD70 AC, I believe, is a former UP SD90 man. Now this next train here doesn't have a normal symbol that you hear on this line.
877 clear, 578 something.
The symbol K77 is usually reserved for an extra train or a local. And tonight, technically, it's both. It's all cars from Delanton, with argon tanks in the mix and only 9 cars in general. An AC44 C6M 4009 leading the way south. The 4009 has an excellent horn.
A
77,
clear 581
Soto. 16R came up later that night with 6959, 1001, and 9820. The same elephant style pair that we've been seeing throughout the video. 10 minutes after the 16R31T would come north with two NS ES44DCs, leading a Canadian National SD75I returning to its home rails. This train starts out on the NS, then goes to the CP, where it ends on the Canadian National. The next night, a monstrous 11R would come south with six different engines, SD60, an ES44AC, an AC44C6M, a -9, an SD70AC, and another SD60E.
by at 587 and siding, over.
That's a wrap.
Later that night, one of the shortest 16 hours of the year, with only 17 cars, would come up north. SD60, SD78, and an AC44 C6M. All the cars in the contest are all covered hoppers. The next day, I would be returning home from school when I hear a horn coming down the line, and it's 30T with an SD70 ACU, an AC44 C6M, and a Dash 9. This train would hold up all the bus traffic leaving the school. Therefore, when the train clears, you'll see a big bus parade afterwards. I got super lucky with this train as I had no idea it was coming. I was just in the right place at the right time. Yes, sir. That weekend would be the NASCAR Cup Series race from Martinsville, and after the race, we needed to eat somewhere. I had found on a brochure in the hotel we were staying at about the 611 Steakhouse. This restaurant was featured all sorts of artifacts, from model railroading, from the actual N&W Railroad, stamps, stickers, and even a map of the entire NW system. Pictures, including NW 1776 and other famous steam locomotives, such as Southern 630 and obviously the NW 611. This restaurant is in Roanoke, Virginia, and it's pretty obvious who the hometown hero is, being NW611. Currently, as I am posting this video, 611 is still at the Starsburg Railroad in Starsburg, Pennsylvania, near Lancaster. This right here is the Lionel MPC era NW611. Even the current owners of the tracks nearby, Norfolk Southern, is represented pretty well with a couple of lamps here and a couple of pictures of some of their engines. One of the coolest features is a model train layout that hangs above the buffet area. It was not running when I was there, but it was pretty cool to look at. This train set right here is really interesting, being the MCH Coors Light bullet train set. The second to last car has a smoke unit and cases of Coors Light inside. I highly recommend, if you're in the Roanoke, Virginia area, you visit this restaurant.
trying to be rude.
And of course, who came next but 16R, as 11R did meet them in Afton. 6953, 4009, and 1163 were in charge of the train. November 1st, the day after Halloween, 11R would come down south with an SD60E, an SD78, and an ET44AC. The SD78C is number 1234, one of the 10 new Progress Rail SD78s that were bought earlier this year, and still in shiny paint. Thank you. Now we switch from train tracks to racetrack.
Xfinity customer Tyler Keaton.
Catch up.
Drivers, start your engine!
Thanks for watching. We don't normally do any racing content, but I thought I squeezed this at the end. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if you like the video, as more railroading content is coming your way very soon. And this was just a little bonus I put on at the end. So, in the meantime, take care. God bless. I'll see you around the bend. Thanks for watching.